Okay, hi, I'm John Carpenter, owner of John's PhillyGrille. We're here in Seal Beach location, one of our three locations, to show you how we do our Philly Tuesdays. So we start with a choice top round that we buy ourselves, and we bring it every day to the store. We trim all the fat off of it completely. What they call a process in butchering is denuding. So we want to denude all the fat and get it very, very lean. So you're trimming, and I have a butcher that works at the shop, and this is his whole job all day. He's just trimming all the fat and just going through. And when he's finished, this is what it's gonna look like here. You can see it's the same piece of meat, a little smaller, of course, because we're losing about 20% of the weight in fat. For us, we wanna get the pure meat, no bone, no gristle, and have it taste just like butter when you're eating it. After we trim the fat, we're gonna put it in the freezer to get it hard. So this is gonna be used tomorrow. This was trimmed yesterday. The reason you want it frozen and then taken out and get a little semi-thaw is you're able to shave it on the slicer when it's hard and get as thin a slice as you possibly can. See how thin we're getting these? This is Philly cheesesteak meat. You can see through it, it's okay for thin. Okay, so after you have your meat, you're gonna take it to the grill. On a, we have two sandwiches. We have a 6-inch and a 12-inch we call the 6-inch a half and the 12-inch a whole. And on the 6-inch, we give you a 1/4 pound of meat. And on the 12-inch, we'll give you a 1/2 pound of meat. But we'll adjust it. Like, some folks don't want to have any onions or peppers or mushrooms. So we give them extra meat on that one because we want it to fill the sandwich. But then if you have a sandwich like on our menu called The Works or No. 4, it has, and I'm going to make that for you here, it has bell peppers, mushrooms, onions, and sweet hot peppers. That proportion of 4 and 8 ounces works perfect. But if it's just meat and cheese, we'll give them a little extra meat to fill up the sandwich.
John, can you tell us about your bread? Where is it made?
Okay, our bread is made local in Huntington Beach, right next to my my other store at a bakery called Di Simone's. And they make traditional Italian rolls. But the main thing what I like about Di Simone's, besides how great the bread is they bake their bread 7 days a week. Some bakers out here close Wednesday and Sundays, and they call it dark days in the bakery business. But we like to have our bread fresh 7 days a week, and Di Simone's supplies us with that bread 7 days. So it's important to have fresh bread, because it makes all the difference in the world. So like I said, we do half and whole. We start out with fresh baked Italian bread every morning. It comes out of the oven fresh. That's a 12-inch whole sandwich. So we have the Philly cheesesteak meat that I just cut, cooking. But all our vegetables are sliced fresh every day. We peel 50 to 100 pounds of onions every day, just to keep up with all the sandwiches. So the onions are sliced really thin. They're not the chopped kind, because chopped kind of onions dissipate and there's really nothing left of them after they cook. So this tastes better to do it this way. So we'll work that in there. We don't use canned mushrooms here. We use only fresh mushrooms, and they're sliced every day. Canned mushrooms are just, again, the taste is not the same. So everything we do is 100% fresh. Put a little oil on the mushrooms to kind of soak up everything. You can see how this is now starting to work in real good with the steak and all the flavors. We cut all our vegetables fresh. These are our bell peppers that we just sliced up. I'll put that on the bottom and get a little flavor of the bell peppers in there. Another signature item that we do here at the PhillyGrille is we make our own hot pepper relish, which consists of four kinds of peppers that I buy, and we chop it up, and all our customers really love the peppers. It's got a little kick to it, so it's a combination of sweet, mild, and hot peppers, but four kind, and we want to make it like a relish. And that is the last thing besides the cheese that we're going to put on this sandwich. This is called the number four, the works. This is my hot side of the grill, and I'll just finish it off over here. So the meat is 100% meat. It's not soaked or marinated in anything because I feel that that's the best tasting sandwich that you can get. Some people use meat that's marinating overnight or processed, and I never like that type of Philly cheesesteak meat. Okay, so we're ready for the cheese. Now the number four, we're gonna put the white American cheese. That's the classic way. We use real cheese. We don't believe in using some places use cheese out of a can. It's called Cheese Whiz. Never liked that. So we use provolone or American white cheese, not yellow, orange American. So this is called white American. And that gives it that cheesy taste, and it melts all through everything really nice. While the cheese is melting, I'll open up the roll. And in Philly, we have a method. We always pinch out a couple of little things in the middle. It's just to make more room for the meat, because the best part of the bread is the crust. You don't really need all that dough in it. This is pretty much ready to go. Made a little extra for me maybe later. I don't know if I'm hungry. And that's what we call a whole number four here at the shop.